Welcome back to another OnLab tutorial. Today we're going to be talking about how to convert audio into MIDI, what you might want to do with that, why you might want to do it, how to convert MIDI to audio, and just kind of walk through not just the workflows, but some of the reasoning involved in some of these decisions and some of the opportunities that each workflow opens up for you. So without further ado, let's just kind of walk through our first scenario. Now, I know that converting audio to MIDI, let's just get this out there right away. I know that there's some negativity built up around this topic with a lot of people, but there really doesn't need to be. Not everyone taking audio and converting it to MIDI is doing it through or for nefarious means. And here's a great example of how you can actually implement this in your own workflow. Let's say you've just spent days working on this project, and you've spent some time building these beautiful keys, and you've got all of these really great elements built up for your mix, but you've been missing that one riff, that one hook, and no matter what you do, every time you sit down at your computer, it just, you know, the inspiration isn't there. So you head over to your buddies, and you're maybe playing around on his piano or something like that, and you come up with this riff. Now, of course, you're not plugged into your computer. Maybe you have your phone on you or something. So you grab a quick recording of yourself, okay? And what we're going to do is just kind of emulate this part of the process, okay? Let's pretend that you have this recording. And what we're going to do is bring that recording into your project now. And we'll just use this little jazz piano riff here. Okay, it's part of the Logic Pro stock library of sounds. So if you have Logic, you can even use the same piece of audio to follow along with. If not, no worries, you can use anything. Jazz Piano Bar 05, if you are wanting to follow along. And we'll just bring that into our project and close our media browser there. And let's just turn on a loop region so we don't have to manage this. Again, this is what it sounds like. Okay, and it's just a piano. So, you know, it's not the sound that you built for your project. Let's get that into that instrument that you made. So first thing you do, just double click on it. And you can actually do this from this sidebar as well. Might as well just do it down here since that's where the rest of the workflow occurs. I'm gonna click on this button here, which activates flex mode. You can say yes, we'll turn on flex. Now this is a little bit different in each DAW, but if you're unsure as to where to find flex or warp mode in your particular DAW, go ahead and run a quick Google search or something. I'm sure you'll find plenty of people showing you how to do it. And we're just gonna change this from flex time to flex pitch, okay? And as you can see now, Logic has identified all these different notes, okay, based upon the pitch values. So now what we're going to do is just ask Logic to convert this MIDI track or into a MIDI track. So now that creates a new MIDI region for us in our project, and we're just going to move that up to this really awesome instrument that we made before for our project and see what this riff sounds like to see if it was really that great. All right, so it came over all right, actually. You know, the timing for the most part is there. and, you know, maybe you just need to adjust it a bit. Maybe you need to drop this down to A or something. Okay, so that's a good one. Now, let's say that you wanted to do something else to this. Maybe stretch part of it in some way or something that you can't actually do with MIDI. So how do you convert the MIDI region to audio? Well, that's just as easy as right-clicking on it and selecting Bounce in Place. Now, my Bounce in Place option is up here in this quick grab area. And the reason why it's there is because it was recently used. So Logic actually puts the most recently used tools or workflows up here. So you just come down here to bounce and join, and you can grab it from here. Again, this is different on every DAW. Go ahead and look it up for yours. So we'll say bounce in place. Sure, we'll leave the original track. We'll create a new track for it. We'll include the audio tail so it doesn't chop it off all weird like. We don't have any plugins running, so we don't have to worry about bypass or not bypass. We'll choose not to overload, and we'll just click OK, and that will create yet another new track. Okay, so there's our new track. And we'll just go ahead and we'll listen to that really quick, make sure that it came through okay. Okay, now you can't use certain features like flex or warp or time stretching on MIDI because it's not audio. There's no audio information for it to warp. So now that this is back in audio, you can turn on things like flex mode or stretching of any kind. So that's one reason why you might want to convert your MIDI to audio. Let's take a look at one more way you can actually convert audio into MIDI and why you might want to do that. Now, in Logic specifically, there's a feature called Drummer. And what that does is it kind of generates these beats automatically for you, which is pretty cool. Uses some interesting technology, and it lays this out in audio natively. So if we just listen to this. Okay, so let's say we're really impressed with that, and we want to convert this now to MIDI, because although we like the beat, we really do not care for the kit at all. You know, this is a regular drum kit, and maybe we want something electronic or digital or something. So let's go ahead and move that. So we'll say here in our convert option, convert to MIDI region. Okay, so now this is instantly changed over to MIDI. And you'll see that it still works with the drum kit, but again, we wanted something else. So, you know, let's just say we had like a drum kit of some sort loaded. We'll just use the basic Ultra Beat kit, and we'll drop our MIDI down there so you can hear what this sounds like. Okay, so there's plenty of reasons why you might want to be moving between audio and MIDI fairly fluidly in your workflows. There's a lot of benefits and a lot of opportunities opened up for your project. And it can also make life a lot easier for yourself. You can save a ton of time using these tools. So certainly do not shy away from them and don't buy into all the negative talk about some of these features, because I'm not sure that there's really such a thing as cheating anymore in modern music production. I mean, let's be fair, this is all looking at a screen and pointing and clicking and stuff. I know that it still involves all of the same, you know, artistic passions and knowledge and everything. So it's just great to open our eyes and minds to the different tools that we have available to us and use them to our greatest benefit while we're here. I mean, why not? Let's make more music. Hope this made some sense. Hope it opened your eyes to some stuff. Maybe it's the first time you've seen a workflow showing how to move from audio to MIDI. And if so, I hope you can put it to use in your very next project. Thanks, as always, for swinging by. Always good to see you. Give us a shout in the comments below. Let us know what you thought of this tutorial. Let us know what you want to see next. Cheers, folks. Take care.